If you're not already using Divi 5, what are you doing? You are asleep. Every week they're releasing amazing new features, and this week is no different. They released a new feature called the Group Carousel module, which is amazing, which lets you cycle through all different types of elements on the page using, of course, the loop builder, which lets you go through products, categories, posts, anything that you can imagine. And it's super simple to do, and you do it right in the Divi builder. And today I'm going to show you how to use this awesome new feature by building this carousel on screen right now. And that's it. Let's get going and build this out right now. To set this blog carousel up, we are, of course, going to start on a new page here. And if you remember in the other video, we covered making this layout here for a modern blog using the loop builder, of course. But here I am on a brand new page. And first things first, we're just going to add a new row. And then within that row, we want to add the group carousel module. And this is where the magic kind of happens. And you'll see here on the right hand side that it already puts a group in there for you, which of course is where you're going to be adding all of your different modules that you want to show. And I'm going to go into the group actually, and I'm going to make that 500 pixels high so that that remains consistent. So sizing, and then the minimum height is going to be 500. And there we go. Now we've got kind of a nice slide. And of course, we're in there editing the group. And this is the thing you want to make sure. And if you ever get lost, you want to go to the left hand here. And you can see the layer view. And then if I expand my row and my column, now we can see I've got the carousel right there. And then within that carousel, I've got my group. So we're all going to get lost in here. It's kind of a different way of thinking about things and interacting with Divi. But it's all good, because once you get it, you get it. Okay, so let's look at my card here, or the carousel that I had finished. So let's break it down. I've got obviously the featured image, so I've got the title, and then I've got the taxonomy right here. Those are the three main elements. So let's go ahead and add this stuff in there. Now I'm gonna go back here to my layout. And then the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a heading module, because essentially what we're doing is we're building out another loop, right? Because this is gonna be a query that runs. So I've got my heading, and I'm just going to put the functional components in here. And then I'm also just going to go ahead and add another module. Now, again, make sure you're in the right spot, because here on the left-hand side within our, oops, I dragged that one out of there. Now see if that happens. You can go ahead and put it back in, or just control Z it. There we go. That's easier. And then if I expand this, you can see the heading. So the next thing I want to add in is a text module. And this is going to be for that taxonomy, right? So let's go ahead on the right hand side. We don't need to do anything there just yet. But since this is in a loop, right? So we want to go ahead and tell it what it needs to loop through. And we're looping through this one group right here. So let's go ahead with that selected and activate loop. And that is going to think for a minute, because now it's looking at what do you have set up here. You've got your query type, you've got, you know, what are you looping through? Of course, the post type posts, and then you can set up all the different things there. But if you haven't watched the other video yet about using the loop builder, there's some extra steps we need to take. We need to go on our heading module, for example, and we need to tell it that it needs to use the dynamic data and pull that from the post. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the dynamic data, and then easy, you just see loop post title, and then it pulls in the post title. And same with the text field here for the taxonomy. So let's go ahead and select that, and then we're going to select post terms, and then it lets you decide what post terms do you want to use. I'm going to use the categories and apply that. And I don't know if you caught that, but you can also even link to the taxonomy pages, which would be the archive page for that, listing all the posts with that taxonomy in there. But we're not doing that right now. But wait a minute, where's our image, right? We've got the titles pulling in nicely now and all that fun stuff. Good question. You're going to go back to your group here. And we're going to do this a little differently, and we're going to say background, and then we're going to use the background image and dynamic data. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the featured image. That is as simple as it can be. And now you can see we can already, you know, scroll through our different posts here, which is awesome. So let's go ahead and just publish that for now. And then we can also just go ahead and do a preview and make sure that everything is wired up and working on the front end. And it is. That's great. So let's go back here. And now, of course, to make it look like our other one, we want to do some design settings and changes to the way we have this. Now, I'm going to take the group here. And then what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to take the first thing, our heading. And what I want it to be is go to the design settings, because I don't want to take up all the space on the page, because I think it's nice if it's like off to the side a little bit. So for sizing, I am just going to go with the max width for this is going to be 50. And then you just want to go and select percent, and then it'll take up only 50% of that space. Now, I also want to have it have a little bit of a background so it shows nicely on the page. I'm going to give it a white background. And then you'll see in my design that I did before, I've got this red hard shadow, if you want to call it that. So we can just easily go ahead and add that in there. So we can go back to the design settings. We'll go to box shadow, and we'll just set up that right there. And then what we need to do, though, is go and make it red and take all the opacity out. You see there? And that works nicely. Now, additionally, I'm going to give it a little bit of space around that text there. So again, with spacing, you can either go and utilize the margins. So maybe you want to put 15 at the top and then 15 at the left. Oh, yeah. This is one quirky thing that I find with Divi 5 is that you have to explicitly either hit enter or whatever the case might be on your settings. Otherwise, if you click out of it, it's not going to save it. Anyway, first world problems. Cool. Next up, we are going to want to put this tag, which is just another text module again. And I am going to give this one also just a background color. Looks like I want to add some padding on that title there too, but we'll do that in a second. And go for background. And for that, we're just going to make it a red background. And then we are going to go ahead and, of course, change the text color. And we're just going to make the text color nice white. There we go. And now to get it in the bottom right-hand corner, as I have here, I'm just going to go ahead and give it some positioning. So on the advanced tab for the text module, go to position. I'm going to say absolute. And then I'm just going to select the bottom right like that. And there you go. Now you'll notice in my design here, I added a little bit of a white space around it just to give it a different look. I'll show you how I did that. That's not super hard to do. I'll just go back to the design settings. And maybe what I'm going to do is just increase the font size to maybe 18. Maybe even 21. How about that? There we go. And just want to also give it a little bit of spacing around it. So we're going to give it both. Well, actually not both. We're just going to give it some padding, as we forgot to do that with the other one. Is 10 good? I don't know. You tell me. Actually, I'm going to do 10 left and right, and then 5 top and bottom. There we go. I like that better. And now for that white space, I'm just going to go ahead and add a border. And I'm going to explicitly add a top border of, let's say, 5 pixels and make the color for that white. And then the same thing for the left border. And select that, give it 5, and then also make that white. Okay, cool. We're making progress. I said that I wanted to add some spacing here for my text on the heading. So I'll just go back into the design settings for that module, go to spacing. And then similarly, I'm just going to put 5 pixels at the top and the bottom. And then 10 on the left and right. Oops, there we go. And there we have it. Okay, so you might want to play with the padding a little bit, just depending on how long the titles are for your site. That's going to be up to you. But we are making progress. Now, we also want to make these arrows look cool. So how do we go ahead and do that? Well, you go back to the carousel, the group carousel module, and you'll see the additional settings that you have here. Now, the carousel module itself has some settings for automatic rotation, center mode, which makes the center post, if you are displaying more than one at a time, I can kind of show you how that looks. So if I just add 3, you'll see that it adds 3 posts here. And then center mode makes that middle one scale a little bit larger, but it looks like in preview mode, you can't really see that. So I'm just going to reset these, but I'll do another video at another time about how you do that. Now on the elements, you can turn off the dot navigation, you can turn the arrows on and off. That's going to be entirely up to you how you want to do that. And that's going to be the bulk of the settings here. But what you want to take a look at also is just go to the design settings. And now we want the arrows to not be so hidden. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the arrow color white, and then I'm going to make the actual background of that arrow just red. It's not beautiful, but this gives you an idea of what you can do. Now, as you guessed it, I also had a bit of a border around my arrows. So I'm just going to add that same 5 pixels and make the color white. And now we are almost where I was with the other layout that I built. If I come on the front end here and I refresh my page now, there we go. So now it's working nicely. We've got our nice little taxonomy there, but how do I read this, right? You're going to want to be able to click through to the post, because what's the point of having a carousel if you can't actually go read the content? That's nice and easy to do again. We're just going to go to the carousel, and then I'm going to select group. Now, on the group, you can go ahead and select the link for that group. And of course, what we're going to be doing is use the dynamic content and just say loop link. And it is as simple as that. And now on the front end, let's save that really quickly and take a look. And now I can click through to that post. That's awesome stuff. And the group carousel is really long overdue within Divi, but it really does allow you to do a lot of different things. I'm going to obviously do more content around this to help you guys use it to its full potential. But I want to show you one more thing is you'll see on my example, I've got like this overlay when I hover it. To get that background overlay, we're going to use the hover settings, and that's not super hard to do. We're just going to make sure that we have our group selected, because that's where the background is applied, right? And then we're going to go to the background. And here we can see we're pulling in the image, but we want this to only happen on hover. So we need to go and make sure that we select hover up here. I'm just going to add a radial gradient and say circular, and then place the gradient above the image. And then, of course, this is how you can kind of see what's going to be happening. And I will just make it black. No. So in the middle, you don't want it to be black. We're just going to put the opacity at 100 then, because we want it to be transparent. And then for the end stop, we can go ahead and, you know, go with whatever type of intensity you want, or color that you want, or whatever you want to do. That's going to be your story. I am going to keep it at this, and I'm going to go ahead and save it now. And then let's take a look on the front end. Bada bing, bada boom. And there we go. Now, there's a quirky thing. I haven't figured out how to make sure that the transitions work nicely when you do enter on hover. Of course, I can add some CSS that would do that, but I think this is maybe just a quirk with where they're at with the Divi 5 alpha. And that's going to be it. This is how you build a very simple carousel for your posts. And we're definitely going to be looking at doing some more stuff with this, so you definitely should stick around. And there you got it, folks. We have built this awesome carousel using the new Group Carousel module in Divi 5. And of course, that layout is available for download in the description of this video. Now, I am making a lot of Divi 5 content these days while I am waiting for my team to finish coding our plugins for Divi 5 so it runs natively. That's Divi Machine, Body Commerce, Ajax Filters, already a beta. So definitely stick around, like and subscribe to this video, this channel, to our products, and check them out, because Divi 5 is awesome and you are going to be awesome by building amazing websites simply, easily with Divi 5 and of course your favorite plugin suite by Divi Engine. Check us out, all the links in the description. Bye for now.